the cadet on board the ship, how is it to be the new and first time on board and sailing on a foreign vessel?
Hello everyone! Welcome on board! So ayan, pag-uusapan natin ngayon ay ang cadet on board. So we have the cadet, first time on board. So siya ngayon ang ating topic dito sa vlog na ito. Okay! Hello everyone! So sa vlog na ito, ang pag-uusapan natin ay ang cadet on board. So meron tayong cadet dito, first time nag-sail dito sa international vessel. So ayan, so mamaya i-introduce natin yung mga sa sarili niya, sino siya at yung mga usual na ginagawa or yung ginagawa ng yung binibigyan namin siya ng training at yung iba ay tinuturo namin sa kanya. At usually yung mga normal lang na job as a cadet. But for the information sa lahat na ang cadet there is no responsibility on board the ship. So wala pong responsibility ang cadet sa ito. So it's more on training. So alalay lang sa mga engineer sa lahat ng mga activities dito sa barko ay kailangan mapamiliarize niya. O lahat ng trabaho dito mapamiliarize niya o yung mga machineries dito sa barko. So ayan, papakita din sa inyo mamaya ang cadet on board the ship.
Ito yung isa sa mga tinuturo namin sa kadete, ang tamang pag-sounding. So, sa ganitong paraan, ay malalaman niya ang mga tank sounding, especially itong fuel tank, how to take the U-leads. Okay. For the new cadets on board, you have to familiarize him not only with the machinery, but also for the paperwork and the daily reading or sounding on board the ship. For this, he will be confident on his job.
Hi, my name is Carl Ian C. Celestial. I studied at Asian Institute of Maritime Studies or AIMS. Oh, I'm gonna tell you why I chose this career or in line of work. Since I was a kid, my father is working on board ship as an engineer, third engineer to be exact. So my father has been my role model since I was a kid. And I got inspired by him because I know his all his sacrifices and I want to see what kind of work he's doing on board. That's why I take this career. So I'm gonna tell you about my first time on board ship. So I'm gonna tell you my experience here, my first on board experience. At first I was really nervous since there's a lot of hindrance. When I say hindrance, I mean you're getting away from your family, friends and relatives, and you will experience everything here alone. The stress, the hard work, all the stuff that you need to remember working on board. So at first I'm really nervous since this is my first time and I really don't know what to do first or what do I need to do. When I got here on board, my engineer told me to familiarize where the machinery is and especially the emergency exit for safety purposes and the emergency equipments that we have on board, especially in the engine room since I work in the engine room. So at first, there are two motormans here. They told me where's the machinery, what will I do, and what's the alarm that I need to accept, and other stuff that I need to remember while working here. That's when I met my engineers, second, third, and chief engineer. So they told me that the third engineer here is at a very young age, he attained the rank of being a third engineer, and that amazed me because, you know, at the age of 26 or 27, I think, he became third engineer. So he told me stuffs, and he asked me questions like what is 4-stroke, 2-stroke, or what is the use of diesel generator, since he's the one who's managing it. And he told me tips on how to study the machinery here. I met my chief engineer. He asked me to study about the machineries, that the operation principles, the diagram, piping diagram, especially piping diagram. So you know what kind of valves you will open when they ask you something. Chief engineer also teach me how to do the paperwork, so I have knowledge about it, like advanced knowledge. The alarms that I need to look and inform the engineer, especially when it's alarm like in the generator or other machineries. So I'm currently 5 months on board now. My first month, I can say it's rough since I'm familiarizing, and I can tell that I'm not that good when it comes to work because I feel the stress, the new environment, but I overcame it with the help of my fellow crew, especially my engineers, who guide me to what to do in my line of work. As an engine cadet, your work here is training on how to be an engineer, or training on assistant engineer. So your daily routine is, during toolbox, they will tell you whose engineer you will assist, either it's third or second engineer, or ETO or electrician. So first you need to familiarize all the tools that you will use, especially when you assist them, because they will ask you to get the tools or find the tools, you will bring it to them. When it comes to the machinery that you are working, what's the use? Ask them what's the use, what's the principle, what's the parts that you are overhauling. So you have knowledge what you are doing. You're not just assisting, you also have the knowledge on what you are exactly doing. I think the hardest part of my job here is when we replace the piston of the main engine. I think it's like I'm just 1 month on board, then we replace the piston of the main engine, and it's really hard because you will need to work in how many hours, and how big the piston is, especially when the waves are rough, it's hard to replace the piston. So I think that's the hardest part of my experience here. Now that I'm 5 months on board, I'm getting familiarized here on board ship. I know my line of work, I know my job, and when my engineer asks me to do something, I already know it because through experience and the guide and tips of my engineers, I use it for my own experience. So I think being on board is hard, but it's really fun and you can enjoy it with, especially when you love the job that you are doing, and especially when you have great engineers and fellow crews that will help you and guide you throughout your career.
This is the incinerator on board the ship, wherein we used to burn the garbage and waste oil. So this is one of the machineries we used to teach the cadet on how to operate this incinerator. So in this way, he will learn this operation. So ito po ang incinerator, kung saan ay sinusunog lahat ng mga basura at mga waste na oil dito sa barko. So isa ito sa kanyang training na tinuturo namin. So meron din tayong regulation before we used to burn the or used to operate this incinerator. So like special area or sec area, we are not allowed to operate the incinerator. Thank you for watching Seafarer Molyo Vlog, and I hope you enjoy and learn by Seaman's Vlog. Please don't forget to share and subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so that you will be notified on my next vlog.